वेलकम यू ऑल। नाउ इन प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टॉपिक ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक सोल्यूट। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक सोल्यूट। सो सर्टन थेरीज आर पुट फॉरवर्डेड to explain the mechanism of translocation of organic solute. These theories are based on various physiological processes. These are nothing but diffusion hypothesis based on the phenomenon of diffusion. As like the glucose or food material is produced by the leaf by the activity of photosynthesis. So here large amount of food is present in the leaves and that is lessly present in the surrounding cell and in the phloem. So food get diffused from one cell to another. This is the base of diffusion hypothesis. Another one, that is the activated diffusion theory, that is related with the sum of the organic substances. They are activated. Here, the plasma membrane playing active role in transport of substances. In activated diffusion theory, the activated substances are diffused and by this way, translocation takes place. Then next is there, that is electroosmotic theory. Now electroosmotic theory, that is related with the ionization of food material. Though this theory has limitation that glucose or some of the organic food material that could not be undergo ionization. But here there is called as electroosmosis, osmotic theory. Electroosmosis means here some of the ions are there. They are forced to carry the organic food material by osmotic way, and by this way food material is translocated. Another theory is there, that is interfacial flow hypothesis, that is related with the flow hypothesis apart from the cell, outside of the cell. Here superficially the food material move through the phloem, but again this theory has limitation. So the most accepted theory for the translocation of organic solute, that is the Munch mass flow hypothesis, that is widely accepted. This theory show the mechanism of translocation of organic solute through the phloem. So Munch mass flow hypothesis, that is also called pressure flow theory, that was proposed by Munch in the year of 1930. Later on this is elaborated by Kraft in the year of 1938. According to this theory, the organic solutes are translocated in mass through the sieve tubes from the source to the sink, that is to the storage region or storage organ where the food is nothing but required. So here organic food material that is flowing in the mass, that is the base of mass flow hypothesis. So mass flow hypothesis is dependent on the movement of food material through the phloem. Now it have been said that xylem moving the water to the upward direction and phloem moving the food material to the downward direction mostly. So this creates a circulation. As like that food material is produced in the mesophyll cell during the activity of photosynthesis, large amount of sugars are produced in the mesophyll cell and this get dissolved in the cell sap, and by the osmotic concentration or maybe by the DPD, what happened, the mesophyll cell increased the concentration. Due to that, water enters into the mesophyll cell from the xylem. And hence, the turgor pressure or pressure potential of the mesophyll cell increases. Due to that, food material is forced or pressurized to move out of the mesophyll tissue to the phloem. So this is the base of this theory. So because of that, this theory is also called pressure flow theory, because here, due to turgor pressure, what happened? Or increasing concentration of sucrose, increasing concentration of water, this forced the food material to dissolve in the water and move out of the cell. This theory is based on this hypothesis. Because of that, this theory also called pressure theory. Now, here in this, this have been demonstrated by Munch, that suppose we have taken two different cylinders, and in this we have been using the two thistle funnel, and we have applied the semi-permeable membrane. Then what happened? In one of the funnel, if we kept with low sugar, and in another funnel, if we kept with the high sugar, and outside of that, in the beaker, we kept the water, distilled water, then what happened? The sugar moves from the one of the thistle panel to the outside of the thistle panel, to the another thistle panel, to this pipeline, just like food is moving through the phloem. Suppose these are the leaf, and from leaf, what happened? Food material is moving from source to sink, where it is low sugar is there, where there is the requirement of the sugar. And it has a high concentrated solution. Because of that, what happened? Continuous sugar is synthesized in the leaves due to activity of photosynthesis. So due to this, what happened? Here, water returns in xylem to replace or to maintain the concentration of this high sugar. So through this semi-permeable membrane, water moves inside, and then after, the food material dissolved in this and transport to this phloem. And by this way, it is transported to sink, where it is nothing but there is need. Again, the water comes out. So by this way, the flow continuously moving from region of higher concentration to region of lower concentration by diffusion. But this is not only the absolute diffusion. Here, xylem and phloem both are running parallelly, and food move in a mass flow. So because of that, this theory also called as pressure flow hypothesis or mass flow hypothesis. Now in this hypothesis, here it has been explained that there is a base for this theory, for the nothing but here sugar that has been dissolved in the water and move from the mesophyll cell by means two ways, that is the simplest way or maybe the apoplast way. So sugar, whatever dissolved in the water in the mesophyll tissue, that moves mostly simplest way, means across the cytoplasm through the membrane, and then after move to the pseudotubes from companion cell, then after to the pseudotube. So solutes are carried in mass, though the simplest, to finally reach the consumption center. At the consumption end, what happened? The food material are either used, or in the root it is stored, or maybe in the fruits, in the tubers, it is again stored. So where there is a need of food, where it has to be required to store, at this storage organ, this food material is nothing but stored, and it is later on converted into starch. Here sucrose is moving or glucose is moving, but starch is not moving. Starch is produced by the storage organ. So as a result, the osmotic concentration and consequently the turgor pressure in these cells are low, where there is low amount of food material. So because of that, the food moves from phloem to the deficient cell or sink cell, where there is nothing but need of food material. Now, in this way, a continuous turgor pressure gradient is maintained. It is established across the simplest between the cells of the source and to the cells of the sink. And water returns to the source through the apoplast system. Now, food is moving by simplest way and water is returning by the apoplast way. Apoplast means outside of the plasma membrane through cell wall. The water moves in between the cell wall to cell wall because cell wall is permeable through which water is moving. So both these are parallelly running together, the apoplast way and the simplest way. Now, here again, it have been mentioned that this is the vessel of xylem. This is the sieve tubes of the phloem. Now what happened? This is suppose the source cell, that is the leaf. Leaf transfer this, the food material to the companion cell, then after to the sieve tube. Food material is having higher in amount, that is glucose, sucrose is having higher in amount in the green leaves. Then what happened? This is absolutely transferred to companion cell and then after to the phloem. And for this purpose here, water is helped from the xylem because what xylem and phloem both are parallelly running together. One is moving the water to the upward direction and phloem is moving the food to the downward direction. So they are in continuous flow. A continuous flow madhe move hotat. And what happened from one of the sieve tube cell or sieve tube element, this food material is moved to the another sieve tube element, to the next sieve tube element. By this way, it is moving through sieve tube element. And where there is a sink cell, where there is a necessary of the food material, there the food material is moved. And the water, whatever that is more in amount, that is again transferred to xylem. Again, that water moves to the upward direction and reach up to the upper part of the plant, that is to the leaves. So these are continuous in the process. So because of that, this is called as continuous flow or mass flow. Mass flow. Mass means that is in bulk. The meaning of mass flow meaning here, that is nothing but bulk. So whatever the pressure, that is nothing but maintain. Here psi is nothing but pressure gradient. So pressure gradient, that is nothing but maintain by means of continuous flow of the food material by the phloem, and the water level is maintained by the xylem. So here, whatever the food material is nothing but produced by the leaves, that is absolutely transported to companion cell and then after to the sieve tube element. Because of that, here concentration gradient increase. And due to that, to maintain this pressure, water comes from the xylem to maintain this pressure, and this flows the here the food material to the another cell by means of due to turgor pressure. Again, this increase in the food material, again the turgor pressure increase, and due to that, this bulkly flow to the next cell. So by this way, food material is transferred to the next tube element. Then after where there is need, then the food material is transferred to companion cell and then into the sink cell. Suppose in the stem, in the flowers, in the fruits, or in the roots, where there is a need of food material, at there the food is nothing but transfer or the glucose is transferred. Now why I am saying most of the amount food at here, not glucose or sucrose, because it is not only moving the sucrose or glucose, along with that amino acids and proteins are also moving by this way. Because by the phloem also amino acid and the proteins also move. So phloem leading a role here at here, where do the solutes come from. Now where this food material is produced now? By the activity of photosynthesis. What happened? In the daytime, the food is synthesized in the mesophyll tissue. That is moved from chloroplast to cytosol. And at the night, this compound together with glucose from stored starch is converted into sucrose. starch is not moving in this. Sucrose is moving, or glucose is moving. Mostly sucrose is moving. So both these steps occur in a mesophyll cell, and sucrose then move into the mesophyll cell via the smallest veins of the leaf to near the sieve element. And by this way, what happened here? The movement of food material takes place. So phloem is playing leading role in this. So here, just like I have said at here, there is two way of movement of food material through the cell, through the walls of the cell, that is called as simplest way. That is the movement of food material takes place by the through the cytoplasm. So that is called simplest pathway. Or maybe another way is there, that is the apoplast way. This is the movement of water takes place through this apoplast way, that is through cell wall. So water is maintained by means of this apoplast way, and food is moving through this simplest way. So here phloem is playing important role. This is nothing but the phloem element. These are the mesophyll element. These are the bundle sheath cell. Then after food move to phloem parenchyma, and then companion cell, and then into the particularly sieve elements. So by this way, food is moving at last to the companion cell, and then to the sieve element. So sieve element and companion cell, that is the phloem, is playing important role at here. Now in the particularly simplest way, here food is moving by the active way, active transport, because it requires the membrane substances to carry this food material from inside to outside, or maybe from outside to inside. To carry these substances from outside to inside, here carrier concept mechanism applied. Carrier concept theory that is applied at here. That carrier molecule moves this food material by using energy through ATP. And by taking this energy, this food is moving, or glucose is moving, or sucrose is moving from outside, inside to outside of the cell. Again, in movement in inner side, same mechanism is taking place. So here, this simplest or apoplast, both this way are requiring the energy. Most of the time, apoplast way does not require the energy, but simplest way require the energy. And that energy is provided by means of the ATP. So continuous there is synthesis of ATP by the photosynthetic activity. And these ATP are present in large amount in the mesophyll tissue. So they are involved in movement of food material from the mesophyll tissue to the outside of the cell. So simplest phloem leading, that is related with the dependent on the species that transport sugar than the sucrose, require the presence of open plasmodesmata. So whenever there is a movement of simplest way, it require open plasmodesmata. What is plasmodesmata? That is nothing but minute opening to the cell wall. So these cell wall openings are there, and through this, what happened here, there is a movement of food material by the simplest way. Ata generally simplest way ni water move to. And apoplast way ni, simplest way ni food material move to, and apoplast way ni water move to. So whatever the movement of food material takes place by the simplest way, that requires the open of the plasmodesmata or open membrane pores. Membrane che pores ya tikani open lagil, otherwise this food could not move. So this requires the active action, and here some of the enzymes are nothing but synthesized for this. Just like it have been said that the larger size of molecule could not move. So because of that, here the sucrose is synthesized in the mesophyll cell, diffused into the intermediary cell, and raffinose is synthesized from this sucrose, and raffinose is having the smaller size. So because of that, it is larger size. So because of that, what happened? Due to larger size, this moved to the another cell and could not diffuse back into the mesophyll cell. So as and when sucrose move, it convert into raffinose, or maybe it is later on convert again convert into sucrose. So both these are able to diffuse through sieve elements. So this is the deep part. You have to remember that only the movement of sucrose takes place. So here phloem is playing an important role in this. In the phloem particularly, sieve elements are involved in transport of sugar. So transported sugar leave the sieve elements of the sink tissue. And then after, what happened, where there is need, it have been stored. So in meanwhile, the short distance transport also takes place. Means the movement of food material from cell to cell. The cells where is there is nothing but sink, or the cell where there is a source. So there is short distance pathway also. And some of the sink cells are metabolically active and they store the food material or sugar and convert it into another form of sugar, that is the starch or cellulose. Cellulose is not stored. Cellulose is involved in the formation of cell wall and other components of the cell. But starch is stored. So whatever the food is there, that food that convert into starch, just like in the tuber, in the form of tuber, in the stem, in the roots, and in fruit itself, another forms of sugars are converted. That is nothing but the fructose, or maybe the glucose. So these another form of sugar is converted, and that is stored in the fruit. So one thing we have to note, that here continuous flow of the food material takes place by the mass. JK food material tayar honar the mass madhe flow honar, mass manje bulk madhe. And pressure flow is theory is dependent on both the phenomenon of phloem and xylem. Both are coupled together and both are involved in the osmotic system or transport of substances, transport of sucrose, and circulate the water. So this is the physiological process, important physiological process that is involved in the transport of food material. So because of that, this is called translocation. So here again, several diagrams are shown at here. That is just here, the source is there, where sugar is produced, that moves to the phloem, and then phloem is moving this food material to the sink, and in replacement water is there, that water is continuously moving to xylem. So just like the storage organs are there, just like sugar beet is there, or maybe sweet potato are there, groundnuts are there, is there a root cha baju mein stem madhe sugarcane is there, in this food material is stored, or maybe in the grasses, stem store the food material. In the members of Poaceae, monocot plants mostly, the nodes and internodes stores the food material. So whatever the food material is there, that is transferred to source to sink in a pressure flow. So this pressure flow is dependent on diffusion pressure gradient, that is psi. As the psi increases, this pressure flow increases. As the psi decreases, the pressure flow decreases. So some of the factors are there that is responsible for this movement of organic solute, that is the temperature. Now, as you know very well, in the ascent of sap mechanism, the movement of food material, the movement of solute, that is moved by means of the mechanism of transpiration. So by transpiration, transpiration pressure, water moves mostly through the xylem. And as the temperature increases, the rate of transpiration also increases. Due to that, rate of translocation also increases with increase in the temperature. So temperature is the factor that is responsible which increase the translocation of organic food material. Then light. Light increases the activity of photosynthesis. So because of that, translocation to root increases as compared to shoot when light intensity increase. Atha why it said? Because most of the part of shoot is involved in photosynthesis. So because of that, the food material mostly moving to the root when photosynthesis occur or when light is available. But when light is not available, just like today is cloudy environment, at that time light is deficient. So due to that, less amount of photosynthesis takes place. So food is lessly moving to the root. It is mostly moving to the branches and leaves where it is nothing but needed. And leafla suddha kadhi kadhi garaj padte food material chi. Javela leaf kontai anna tayar karu shakat nasel. Jasa young leaves astat, they could not take part in photosynthesis. So at that time food is moving. Then metabolic inhibitor. Carbohydrate translocation get inhibited by the metabolic inhibitor. Several factors are there, just like abscisic acid that stops the flow of food material. So most of the time, whenever there is no synthesis of hormone, auxin or cytokinin, at that time abscisic acid increases. And due to that, food moves, do not move to the leaves or other parts of the plant. Due to that, plant become undergo decay or dry. So due to metabolic inhibitor, this is also the factor that is responsible for inhibition of the translocation. Then another mineral deficiency, absolutely you know very well. In previous part, we see the mineral deficiency role. That absorption and translocation of sucrose is again initiated by the leaves or facilitated by several mineral deficiencies, just like boron. Boron is needed in transport of substances or some of the substances also move through the phloem also, just like phosphorus, calcium, potassium, or magnesium. These are the essential elements that move again through the phloem also. At the phloem madhun kadhi move honar? Whenever the plant undergo abscission, javela plant leaf abscission dakhvel, pana jeva galta jhadachi, javela kay hoto? At that time, जे काही लीप मध्ये जे फूड मटेरियल असेल ते फ्लोएम मधून ट्रान्सफर होणार दुसऱ्या प्लांटच्या पार्ट मध्ये स्टेम मध्ये ट्रान्सफर होऊन जातं आणि जे काही न्यूट्रिएंट आहे त्याच्यामध्ये नायट्रोजन फॉस्फरस पोटॅशियम मॅग्नेशियम कॅल्शियम हे सगळे मिनरल्स फ्लोएम मधून ट्रान्सफर होतात सो दिस ट्रान्सफर टू डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन म्हणून फ्लोएमची डायरेक्शन ठरलेली आहे डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन आणि झायलेमची डायरेक्शन ठरलेली आहे अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन आता फ्लोएम फक्त डाऊनवर्डच डायरेक्शन होतं असं नाही अपवर्ड पण आहेत अपवर्ड कोणता पार्ट जिथं वरच्या बाजूला फ्रूट येतात तर फ्रूटच्या दिशेने किंवा फ्लॉवरच्या दिशेने लॅटरल साईडला ब्रांचेसच्या दिशेने आणि डाऊनवर्ड साईडला जास्त कारण जास्तीत जास्त ब्रांचेस हे काय असतात डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शनला असतात अपायकल पार्ट फोटोसिंथेसिस जास्त करतो सो दॅट फ्लोएम मुव्हिंग द फूड मटेरियल टू द डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन मोस्टली बट इट इज मुव्हिंग द फूड मटेरियल ऑल्सो टू द लॅटरल एज वेल एज द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन ऑल्सो But xylem has the fixed direction, that is upward direction. Then another role is there, the factor that is the hormone. Translocation of sucrose is much more efficient in the presence of growth hormone. I have already said it. In presence of auxin and cytokinin, the growth is properly takes place so that mass flow also taking place high in amount with compared to the where hormone is not less hormone is not present ja tikani hormone changly present asel just like auxin or cytokinin at their translocation is mostly occur ani jitha anti in particular inhibitory hormones ahet anti growth hormones ahet jasa abscisic acid kiwa gibberellin at their the translocation is lessly occur tithe translocation kami hoto so this is all about the factors that affect the mechanism of translocation. Now in this we have been seen at here the Munge mass flow or pressure flow hypothesis that explain the mechanism of translocation of organic solute in the plant. So here it complete this topic. Now the topic is open for discussion. You may ask any difficulty or any doubt at here. So is there any doubt? Okay.